looking a bit static. You know, start with the last page. That's the conclusion of this morning. So I forgot to show this slide. Thank you very much. That's the thing for your attention. That's it. This is one of the exhibitions in Korea. I was the co-organizer of one of these digital technology in this international meeting of information display. And the past year was the number 10. Okay, I think this morning we talk about this influence switching. The other, since I have two slots, I think yesterday I have a whole bunch of information that did not finish. Hopefully you will enjoy that I try to entertain you with additional information. So in this morning we talk about that molecule rotate in the plane, and this type of display is called in-plane switching. Means the liquid crystal molecules just like this with a dipole, either positive or negative, depends on where the dipole in the long axis of molecules or in the short axis of molecules. The only difference is either you design the orientation at the zero voltage state, in the dark state, or in the bright state. Most people design in the dark state. And then when you apply fields, it's rotated to the direction around 45 degrees in between across the polarizers, so you get the maximum light transmission. So that's kind of information we learned this morning. So this afternoon, we are learning the other technology. It's called vertical alignment. Like in-plane switching was first invented by the information known for years, but I think the first display was made by Hitachi in Japan. And then that technology licensed to a shop, it's called in-plane switching. LG displays are using this technology. Qimei Optoelectronics in Taiwan also making this, and they are the major IP. Now it's part of this Hong Hai technology in Taiwan. They are the major production of this IPAC displays. So if you are using that, you are using this type of technology. The other one is for high contrast, very nice dark state, because of they are aligned molecules aligned perpendicular to the substrate. And then at zero voltage, it's perfectly dark state. Although there's another technology that is very, very nice and is competing with liquid crystal technology. It's called organic light emitting displays. And this type of materials at dark state perfectly dark because the light can get turned off. Now, unfortunately, this technology still has issues to be solved. For example, that the organic material to allow that light emission of blue, green, and red. There's a differential degradation for this blue light to go off faster than your green light. And if you have iPhones, anybody have iPhone or Samsung, Yvonne has this iPhone. Some of you, if you have some of these Samsung's Galaxy, you might have some problem too. The OLED displays, the reason that they put it on iPhone is they can last longer. They have the technology to shut it off, shut the pixel off. And then when you are not using that, it saves some energy. And also they put in, instead of RGB, red, green, blue, they put in another subpixel called white. Okay? So in that case, they can increase the light brightness of the device without sacrifice overdriving those pixels. So those were very important technology to make sure that when you have the iPhone or those smartphones, it can last longer than 1 year or 2 years. And then after that, you will ditch into the trash can or recycle bin, you buy another one because of the technology improved. So all the technologies are competing with LCD still have as a few years to go, although some company like Sony make 11-inch of this OLED display 2009 they're on the market. It costs $2,000 for 11-inch. compared to 42-inch to 55-inch $2,000. So I guess those technologies, once they are reached to the mature state, the only thing competing is the price, like the commodity price. So I guess this type of VA technology also has some advantage, and there are some rooms to improve. Here is something that we can take a look. For this vertical line with the VA display, you can see that in the dark state, the liquid crystal molecules align perpendicular to the substrate. And then there are two types of technology. One is earlier that comes from Fujitsu, that they use this kind of surface protrusion. This protrusion roughly depending on the width of the base, the height of this protrusion. There's some advantage and then disadvantage. Advantage is, you know, they can create some kind of fringe field effect nearby this protrusion. The liquid crystal molecule of align vertically, but it's tilting. So it creates some kind of a concave type of a structure near that, near this protrusion. And then when you apply field, the orientation of those molecules kind of providing this wide angle view if you from look from this direction, that direction, or this direction, that direction. A slightly difference compared to this direction, that direction. So there's some improvement because of there's a light leakage caused by this protrusion. The other technology to create a polynomial mean angles is like this. You know, at zero voltage, all the liquid crystal molecules align perpendicular to the substrate. You know, when you apply field, you see that because of the specific design by the slits, of the one of the electrodes, it's not matched well with these data lines or this. So these common electrodes and data lines, scanning lines, they are not matched. So when you apply field, it's also causing some kind of concave or convex type of field distribution inside of the cell. The effective fields may drive this not perfectly aligned, but you can see that creating multi-domain structure. Plus, once you add these zigzag electrodes, you can have more domains created by this type of technology. But this is the earlier version of that. The differences of this is they are trying to avoid, you know, infringe each other. In display industry, normally you see that today, one company suing the other, you know, because they use their technology. So the other company has to counter suing the other, you know, because of, you know, some of the technology maybe they are using without the knowledge. So for this type of vertical lighting, they have some advantage. They have a very wide beam angle. They either using protrusion or this formal slit, this electrical slits. They have a high contrast ratio with optical condensation scheme because there's some direction they have a specific light leakage. They have a low color shift, that's the advantage of this type of device. So you can see, you know, this optical isocontrast switch between off and on state. You can see that in the center side is a high contrast ratio, and then they are expanding to about 10 to 1 optical contrast in the dark and bright state. On these three quadrants here, you see that slightly they have a lot poor contrast compared to this perfect 0, 90, 180, and then 270. And so in this case, that if you view it through this direction, you have good contrast. But if you are viewing through this direction or that direction, slightly at the light angles, you're missing something. So this is the reason that they need an optical condensation beam. You see that your eyes, so you look at from that direction is pretty good. But if you look at from this direction and that direction, the optical contrast is not that good. So what the industry does is they use a wide beam angle beam, normally this type of polymer thin films that has this thin optical axis, either chosen this plot, this negative A or positive C. Sometimes they use negative C and this maybe a combination of bilateral pins or all type of methods to compensate this light leakage. What in some cases they were using some kind of symmetric type of this arrangement of deep crystal alignment, and then to create a wider wind angle direction. For example, sharp using the polymer walls in each single pixel. And then, so this liquid crystal anchoring on the surface, it's kind of a radial distribution of orientation. So in that case, you can have a wide wind angle from all directions. So you can see that this type of device is more symmetric compared to the conventional VA model. So that type of improvements. So in this work, we're trying to overcome one of the major issues, that is the response time. So we're working on some technology by growing these polymer nanospikes, and then using this kind of polymer nanospikes to assist this liquid crystal alignment in the off state. Okay, we remember that at off state, it's because of zero voltage, liquid crystal gets switched to the direction almost parallel to the substrate. Once you turn the field off, they have to go back to its original state. And in that case, that this relaxation process is controlled by the viscosity of the system. So, in order to assist this, there are multiple ways to do it. You can do some tricks, but in this case, that since we are interested in some materials that assist this alignment, so I'll tell you what we have done. So first of all, we form this surface localized polymer spike, and then at low polymer contents, we can increase this light transmission. But once you increase this polymer concentration in the mixture, it causes some light scattering. We can also enhance this surface anchoring. So that's what we're talking about here. This Fujitsu AUO also showed this similar work recently, and then they were saying that possibly they can form this polymer network when they apply electric fields. The reason they want to apply electric fields during the formation of this polymer network is to create multi-domain structure. So after that, the polymer network can form at the surface. So sometimes the inactive areas of the protrusion restrict the transmittance of the panel and creates some light leakage. So that was the problem, and that's the major improvements by using this technology. So the way to do it is like this. Again, you may have to coat roughly around a couple 20 nanometers, 200 angstroms of this polyimide pins. That is almost vertical line or side chains that allow you. I think earlier this morning, the speaker trying to talk about this creating polymer brushes on the surface. But in liquid crystal display technology, it's been known that if you have a polyimide, if you don't know what's polyimide is a rich rock polymer on the backbone. And then with some of these long archaeal chains, hydrocarbon chain, roughly around 12 carbons length, and then 12 to 18, and then you can create, depends on the density. In this case, because of the side chain has low surface energy, okay? The main chain is more polar, the side chain is less polar. So once you sprinkle a certain thickness of this polyimide film, automatically this side chain has low surface energy, they like to stick out in the air. So that's how you get this kind of homogeneous alignment. But you can also, using the lecithin in the lab, you like to create this kind of alignment. You can dissolve lecithin in hexane, and then you just dip your glass into that. You dry your organic solvent in the inside of the film food. And then once it's dry, put in the oven, make sure all the solvent is being removed. And you can achieve this similar type of alignment. And you can see in this cell structure, top and bottom substrates of this kind of vertical line with this polyimide pins. Then you fill the liquid crystals with some percentage of monomer, in shining light. And then the technology-wise, you know, in our lab, we try with multiple ways, and here I show you a few ways, methods of making that. So after that, making this, we can have all those polymer types on the substrate surface. So very few of them stays in that. You know, so why do you need a spice? If you are a good athlete or you're a good football player, in this country you're a good football player. Those football players, they want to run faster. You know, they want to drill the balls. Just pass those defenders. They need shoes with spikes, right? Because that give you the anchors almost on the grass that will allow you to maneuver, you know, much better than your defender. So spikes is like that. Well, you can see that on the polymer surface, we also create all kind of spikes with high and low, although it's not very uniform. But roughly, the density depends on the polymer concentration initially. And then some of them, they may not grow nucleates high enough like this, you know. In average-wise, about 100 nanometer to 140 nanometer. The diameter here is a scale part of 1 micron. So you can see that the diameter of this spike is roughly around exceeds about 100 nanometers. So the way to prepare that is you can use double side exposures like what we did in the early 2000s. That we are using this to prepare this flexoelectric device, making this periodical fibers lay down on the surface. So what we did is we shine the light on one substrate, flip them around, you know. Shine light on the other substrate. So in this case, I give you some examples. Suppose we fix this polymer concentration at 3%, and then fix liquid crystals with 0.2788. This is kind of a super coordinate for this negative direction isotropy. Liquid crystals roughly around minus 5, somewhere around that. 5.7, I'm sorry. So you can see that sometimes this is the sample without any polymer. So you can see it can be switched from a dark state to bright state with this with this threshold voltage much lower compared to once you put the polymer inside. You can see that depends on how you make those polymers. And sometimes the light intensity of the polymer varies. So you can see some of the sample one, sample two, and sample three. This strong UV light, this handheld UV light, so roughly around 4 milliwatts per cent square meter. This one with the intensity roughly around 15 milliwatts per cent square meter. So you can see that the light intensity as I shown you this morning, right? This preliminary information is very important. Once you learn the basic, you can apply this to other technology. So the response time of this vertical line, the liquid crystal displays, is governed by these equations. On the right side, you can see turn-on time is proportional to this rotational viscosity and cell gap thickness. So if you like to have a device that switches the lowest low voltage, you certainly want to use the thin cell gap. But you may also want to maintain the same kind of optical retardation value. To do that, you may have to use a higher optical dimensions liquid crystal. It's inversely proportional to your threshold voltage, your ratios of applied voltage over this threshold voltage ratio. And then it's related to, because this is a vertical alignment liquid crystal, and you want to switch from the vertical alignment to this almost parallel to the substrate. In this case, the elastic constant of bend, K33, is the bend elastic constant that in general is the largest value of those three parameters, elastic parameters, the splay and twist. And so in that case, that if you want to have this turn on time faster, you may want to use a liquid crystal with large K33 value. Certainly in the turn off time, you can see that the voltage is, the turn off restriction voltage is zero. So in this case, this absolute value is equal to 1, so the leftover is like this. You know, it's governed by this delta gap, viscosity of liquid crystal, and also the elastic constant. So in that case, that you want to improve that, you may have to either choosing the right type of liquid crystal or enhance this surface anchoring. So when you turn off the, this field and the liquid crystal reorient back to its original state, it will go back to faster. Here is just one example. You know, in the pure the vertical line, the liquid crystal cell, you can see that turn on and turn off. It is pretty long. It takes a long time, more than 50 milliseconds. But in this case, if you have a polymer surface spikes, you can see that the turn on and the turn off has been dramatically improved. If you have a double site with a low intensity UV, and sometimes that polymer spikes forms a different kind of density. And then also the shape and size is quite different. So in that case, it also improves a little bit. So we want to take a look. This total response time, if there's a no polymer network, roughly around 52 milliseconds with a polymer network, different type of light intensity, you can see that in general it improves roughly around from 20% to 40% depending on this surface polymer morphology. So shortening in four times as high, sometimes as high as 45%. And then there's a peak voltage side increase due to the some of this fibrous appearance. So let's take a look of inside of the cell. You know, the cartoon shows that actually the cartoon is generated by Vladimir, you know, who's sitting here, and you can ask him. Yeah. The image is showing that the polymer spikes over here is from 100 to 200 nanometers high. The spaces is about 5 microns spaces. So in this case, that the scalar bar is 1 micron, you can see that the density is quite different from the top and bottom substrate. If you just shine on one side, here is the top view, about 20 degrees image. That you can see that the spike location is not so well arranged. So, but in general, you can see that if this is 3% polymers, some of them they are kind of interconnected. You know? So that there's a trade-off for this type of technology using high concentration. In this case, because of dislocated or this kind of a link on a spike, that may cause some problems. So in general, you want to grow the spikes. You can see that the spike from the side view. The side view here is a 1 micron bar here. So the side view show you a very nice spike. You know, so improvements like this, you know, since 3% is too much, you know, so we try to use either a low concentration, 0.2% or 1%. And in general, in shine a light, you can use all kind of methods, using two lights, and later on I show you the two lights. So cell gap, keep the cell gaps for about 3.5 micron. In this case, here the data shows that this is 0% polymer. This is 0.2% polymer, and that's a 1% polymer. So in that case, that there's another, there's a very negligible difference in light transmission. And then, but the threshold voltage, you see that 1%, 1% slightly higher than the 0.2%, and then turn on voltage is slightly higher than 0.2%. The response time, wise, I think. Roughly, we say that the 0% polymer is roughly around 52. For 0.2%, there's not much improvements here. For 1% polymer, it shows roughly 27 versus 52 milliseconds. So that's pretty impressive. But you may also ask me a question, right? You know, then how can we see this video raise in a very nice sharp image? And you know, in the meantime, that they are not using this. You know, the next generation of VA mode produced by Sharp, they're using this this type of technology in the generation 10. But generation 10 lines means what? They are classified by the size of the mother glass. Okay? The generation 10 would be pretty long in terms of 2.5 meters long and then 2.25 meters in width. So those types, they were trying to use those slicing into a different kind of size of the display. And in that case, that they can make a large panel to be effective. But they also want to improve the contrast ratio, the response time. So that's the one of the technologies under the consideration. The other one is using photo alignment. We can talk about that in the future. In the future summer workshop, hopefully Yvonne just bring me back. We can continue to discuss that. And single side UV exposures, you can see with single side, one substrate has more dense these are fibers than the other. Use the two lens, okay? You might think this is difficult to achieve, but in industry they can have all kind of trick. They just use a mirror to reflect it to the other side on the transportation is built. And so in this case we were using this 1% 0.2% just for comparison with double exposure. Well, again, low quantum concentration has a lower threshold compared to 1%. And then the tandem voltage is also slightly higher with high concentration. The response time-wise, in this case, the turn-off time is roughly about the same turn-on slightly different. The turn-on slightly different because of there's a difference in terms of surface morphology. Let's take a look at that makeup. So in this case that we kind of plot with this single side and dual UV exposure all together. So you can see that with these four lines, they are not much difference in this light transmission. So that's the major achievement. But there's a difference in terms of the turn-off time, but the turn-off time is roughly about the same. So to take a look at those, we'll see. Response time for those VA without polymer is roughly around 52 milliseconds. For those cells that with 1% polymer single side, and then this dual UV lens, and you can see that there's a slightly difference. For 0.2%, there's not much differences. But the four times of those devices is slightly higher and slightly faster compared to this four times of this no polymer. If we normalize that cell gaps, and then roughly I think for 1% polymer, it shows a significant improvement. Here is the response time plot versus the polymer concentration. You can see that for those 0.2%, they are almost insignificant in terms of improving this response time. But once you reach to 1% and then 3% further improvement, the 3% you may have a sacrifice of this light transmission because of scattering. So on the other hand, we also want to test that if you form in this polymer network by applying the field to create multi-domain structures. So the comparisons here, this is 0% and this is 0.2%. This is 1%. You can see that the threshold voltage slightly increased from 2.0 something to almost 3. And then the 10 ohm voltage here is also dramatically increased. The response time wise, the rise time, this one is out of battery. Can I borrow yours? Okay, so you can see that the turn-on time slightly increased because of too strong of the anchoring, increased anchoring, but the turn-off time is improved. So here is the kind of response time overall for the pictures that you have seen that the control is, in this case, we normalize everything. The control is about 42 milliseconds. And then we use some 1%, it shows at least 25% improvement with applying the electric field. So remember, this is applied electric field. When you apply electric fields, the informal network may have additional tilting. So that could cause some of this. So we want to take a look why this is improved. So in general, the cells shine under this high intensity UV, a good dense polymer domains and then scattering more light. Random polymer fibers increase the light scattering and it also shows slow the response time. This electro-optic property are polymer morphology dependent, so that's what we observe. High density surface localized polymer spikes and fibers increase the rise time. That's because so you get either disrupted alignment or it's too strong the surface anchoring. For high polymer concentration, they increase the surface anchoring, that we know that. Alignment effect is proportional to the surface and surface areas of both the polymer network, and high polymer concentration forces strong anchoring alignment and a large network size of polymer network that also increase this alignment effect but also cause problem. So to understand what's going on, you may want to model this. There's a way to simulate that. So if you have a polymer spike like this, you have difficulties of line, depends on what direction of the field you apply. You apply this this direction perpendicular to this spike. That's what we have for the vertical alignment. In some cases, you apply this direction, that's the opposite direction, just to from the planar to that direction. This is also unwanted structure. If you have a polymer network inside and or implant orientation. So this boundary condition using tensor relaxation method that you can achieve a little bit about this simulation of the angle that you tune to. So on polymer network, a strong parallel alignment due to the van der Waal interactions, orientation angle in the ball. Sometimes you apply the although on the surface is a well aligned following that polymer network direction. In the block, there's deviations of that, so that's there's the theta zeros. So this elastic energy per unit length per cylinder, you can use this integration equation to integrate that the elastic energy in the block. Certainly you can use a tensor relaxation method. You have this liquid crystal directors and then free energy of the system. Since it's dominated by this elastic fan constant, and so with those tensors, you can create all kind of equations here, and then sub those into those free energy of the system, and then you can also add one term of this dielectric coupling, and so with that, you can certainly simulate at the end. You can simulate if you know the liquid crystals. This elastic constant, you plug this, and you will know that the free energy and then the tilted angles at the, in the ball as a function of the free energy of the system. Once you have a higher free energy of the system, then you can have this tilt. Sometimes we can estimate from that SEM morphology, right? The radius of that is roughly around 100 nanometers, so we kind of estimate that around 100 nanometers. And then the unit free energy is roughly proportional equal to the bend elastic constant. So in this case, then you will be able to estimate that the effective field, and then the single cylinders in kind of ideal condition, about how much of the anchoring of liquid crystal nearby those polymer spikes. So those were possible. So if you done with that, then you know that you have proved yourself. You not just do the experimental. You're using the simulation to study to see if that effect that matches that your claim. So the claims are here's there are some polymer nano spike the direct masses of free with electric field free. And sometimes we can have electric fields applied to create multi-domain. So improvements of this response time range from 20 to 40%, achieve 1%. Sometimes if you want a high transmittance, that's important for display industry, because you want to bright image, with a very low energy supply to the big light, so you don't have to crank up the big light. And for a mobile device, that's also important. Multi-domain is possible with 0.2% polymer and with electric field applied, building formation of spike. So I guess in this set of information, I will just stop right here. Okay. But this is the other group of people, and also they thank you very much for your attention.